What's up guys, it's ArcBricks here, and welcome to a little bit of a haul video from the Lego store and eBay as well. This is all the stuff I'll be selling and then just some stuff that I got for myself. This is kind of my first video. I don't really know how I'm going to format these. I think I'm just going to do pretty much hauls and then anything interesting that happens that's Lego related. And you can kind of see my room isn't really filled, it's more skateboards and then my setup for gaming because I do my gaming YouTube channel. But under my bed's all my personal stuff actually, so like my figure boxes are there, and then I have a couple boxes with the sets I have still put together when I want to do like a mocker display or something like that. And then I also have a few other things under my bed, a lot of broken down sets that I've gotten since I've came to this house, which is, it's just awful outside. Pretty much most of my other Star Wars sets, creator sets, city sets, Indiana Jones, all of those, they're all broken down and they have their figures and their instructions and stuff. They're all put away in big plastic tubs. I got like 8 tubs full of organized bricks and stuff. They're almost all at this house. There's still some in storage I would like to bring home so I can get all my Star Wars sets out and keep them in my room, because I just like to have all my Star Wars stuff in here. But pretty much I have a couple skateboards underneath as well I need to bring out so I could have some more room so I could do more videos. I kind of want to show off some of my collection and stuff. I think I'm going to first just get into my Lego store haul. And pretty much what I got today was I got this Creator Diner set. I'm going to do most of my videos clearly Lego Star Wars related, but I did get this, and I got it for my mom because she does the big creator set builds and stuff. I really like them. I don't have anywhere to put them. She does. She's got shelves in one of her rooms. We kind of want a crafting room in the house, but we're waiting for certain individuals to move out. Anyway, this one's actually super cool. I kind of like the whole Elvis character with his pink Cadillac, the crazy diner theme, the glass pieces itself, the different design here, the some more unique characters like the boxer and stuff. I really like these, especially if you do big city mocks. I would like to do more mocks and stuff, but like I said, as you can see, I don't have that much room. Literally, this is me in the corner of my room, and that's my bed, my another skateboard rack for skateboards I collect, my setup, my shelf, my door to the hallway, closet, and then into my bathroom. My closet's full. That's literally my dresser, and everything's in there. So yeah, this is just kind of more for my parents than anything, because they like doing their big modular builds. This is what they're into. Now for some stuff that I got for myself. I got, since I was going to the Lego store, I really wanted to spend over $75 on a Star Wars set so I could get this. I'll get to that in a second. But I haven't been getting a lot of sets because I don't really care for a lot of the new ones, but I did really like how they came out with the 20-year anniversary sets, and I really, really wanted Princess Leia because I don't have her. The last one I needed is Luke. I just needed to get that set, but if I was going to go to a Lego store, I was going to get something, you know, pretty big. Yeah, so I got the Slave 1 set. It's got a bunch of new characters as well and some repetitive ones, but I haven't had the Slave 1 since 2006, so I figured this was a good build. I'll probably build it for a little bit, and then I'll break it down and put it to the side if I ever feel like bringing it out one day. But this is the real reason another big reason I want to go to the Lego store today was to get this. This is one of those, if you spend over $75, you get one of these freebies, and this is a really cool one. I actually like this. It's not a polybag figure, it's just, it's like a mini mock of, I believe it's just called Battle of Hoth. Autofocus. Yeah, Battle of Hoth 20th anniversary. So this is cool. I'm not gonna open this one. I'll probably try to get another one at some point. I'm just gonna put it to the side, and I'm gonna decide if I'll ever open it and keep it, or I might sell it later down the road. Right now they're already going for like $50, so I'm just gonna put it and let it gain value. But like I said, I got this one's coming with Princess Leia. I'll be building this one today, and I need to make some room under my bed so I can put it away when I'm done. This is already the other three I have on my shelf. I'll have displayed, which is Vader, Solo, Han Solo, and Lando. These are all the 20th anniversary, as you can see. Now into the stuff you guys will have access to on my Instagram, which will be linked in the description, is my eBay haul. All right, I want to start with the not as wanted. I know everyone wants clones, but I'm gonna start with some other stuff. I got eight Imperial figures. I got four Scout Troopers. These are all the older ones, and they're all in pretty good condition except this guy. This guy is very yellowed, but I'll probably just auction him and see if anyone would like him. For anyone who wants to claim all four, I might just do a lot. My warranty covers big cracks, like big side cracks, but I'm not going to cover yellowing. If someone wants them, they want them. Got a Sand Trooper, an AT Walker, a Snow Trooper. It didn't actually come with a Snow Trooper. It just came with a helmet, but I happen to have a body sitting to the side, so I was able to put them together. And another Stormtrooper. In the back, it came with what's left of two of the Episode 3 Phase 2 Clone Troopers, a couple of helmets, and then an Imperial Officer that's missing his helmet as well. Into some of my cheaper figures that will be for $3 claims. Clearly, droids aren't going to be that. They're going to be even cheaper. A couple R2s. It got Newt Gunray. We got two Jar Jar Binks, which I don't know if anyone can tell me if I could lay these guys out. The one has leg printing, and I don't know if he's like worse worn or not. I don't know if he's a unique figure. If anyone can give me some info, I'll shoot you a deal on Instagram. And we got Han Solo, little Han Solo, Anakin. These are gonna be my $3 claim area, which I'll have on auction, which will be a new thing I'll be implementing. And into more unique figures, I got some Ewoks. Didn't mean to bust that off you. These guys I know are worth a little bit more. I'll see what they go for. If not, they might go into my $3 claim area. Some Rebels, which will be in my, which will be a part of the lots I will be putting. Essentially, what I'll be doing when I have my base plate set up, I will have an area for $3 claims at the end of the auction, or unless someone wants to claim right away. And then I'll have my armies, which everyone is typically what they want to do is a clone army, a stormtrooper army, rebel army, droids, whatever. I'll have those in lots to put up for auction, you know, two stormtroopers, two scouts, whatever. And then the same with these. And then I'll have my unique figures that are worth a little bit more and see what they go for. Clearly these guys aren't unique. They'll be part of their army stuff as well. But like these Ewoks are, I know this guy's expensive, he's worth about 15 bucks. I know this Gungan soldier's worth a little bit, and same with this older Endor Leia. And then of course for the grand prize I got was a Chrome Stormtrooper. I don't think this guy knew what this was worth in his lot, and I got a pretty good deal for 45, well, actually a little bit more because I put a couple together. Or maybe less, because it came with some other ones that I just throw to the side. Essentially, if I get random city figures or anything that's not Star Wars related, I throw it into a sandwich bag, and once it gets full, I sell it for like 15 bucks of just random figures and accessories. But he had this, and I don't think anyone he knew what it was worth. It's sealed. It's got a couple tears up here. But I already sold it. I know these go for like 75 bucks, but just because, you know, I got a pretty good deal. I threw the guy a good deal. He got it for $55, already shipped. So pretty much 50 bucks for that. Of course, I know you guys want to see the clone troopers. I got two bomb squad, four normal, just phase one, a gunner, and then an episode three pilot, which I don't think a lot of people collect the episode three. I know some do, some don't, but these guys will definitely be there. This will be part of my second auction coming up. Clearly I got more figures that I'm getting. These aren't just gonna be it. I don't think that's enough. I typically, once these drawers get filled, which they're not too much, this is the bag I fill up with random figures. These are my $3 claims that I will have up. R2's clearly not worth, old Ben, Barriss isn't worth that much. My more unique figures, which is like Obi-Wan, Confederacy Guard, I believe this is called the Dewback. And then this is all my army building stuff, which is clones, Imperials, droids, which this is all empty still because of my last auction and stuff. But yeah, that's pretty much all going to be in there as well. And then I have other stuff that will be ready. I still have the Star Destroyer. That won't be part of the auction. I don't think it would go. I have a gunship that's sold. And then this stuff, I have a spider droid, a bunch of those big figures and stuff. These are probably just going to get put up for auction because when they start sitting and not getting sold and stuff, I'll end up throwing them on auction. But I'm not too much in a hurry to get rid of that. And then I got bricks. Some are just filler, like blue, yellow, red. The whites I know people want if they're doing like a snow mock or something. Some others that are filling up, glass pieces, brown pieces, the gray pieces, that's still filling up. And then of course this is just like bags and brick separators, tape, receipts and all that. My bubble mailers are where I print everything for shipping. Not in here, I don't have room. But that's my receipt book. But I just want to kind of do an overview of what I got for my haul and stuff. And then along with, this is my area for selling. You know, I got a receipt book and this is where I do my auctions and photos and stuff in my light box. And that's kind of it. And then all my personal collection, like I said, is under my bed. I don't really have a lot of it on display besides my 20th anniversary figures. It's just, I don't know, I just like my room just super clean and stuff. I'm super OCD about this kind of stuff. Bed's already made. And this room wasn't clean just for a video. It's always like this. But yeah, I just kind of want to do an overview, kind of an introduction on everything I'm doing because this is my first video. And, you know, eBay haul, Lego store haul, personal collection, selling area, and then some other stuff. I'll be linking my gaming channel in the description if you're interested into more mature content and stuff like that. There's a couple vlogs on there as well if you want to get to know me and see what I look like. Check the description below for my Instagram and stuff if you guys want to check out auctions and see what I have for sale, and or if you want to just see what I'm posting. And if you're interested in my gaming channel, that will be below as well. It's been Arc Bricks, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.